Yeah, I know you want to lose weight, and I know you want to keep it off. So why do you keep dieting? Because yes, look at your history. You diet, you lose weight, then you gain it back. Otherwise, why are you looking for another diet? Why are you searching for anything? You would be in your happy, healthy weight range, and you'd stay there. My name is Meg Moranis. I'm the voice of this channel. And here, what we're learning to do is reconnect with the beautiful, wonderful gift of hunger. Yes, hunger, you guys, don't be afraid of it. Use it. I like to say, harness your hunger to lose weight. And what do I mean by that? When you diet, what ends up happening over a period of time is that you actually lose your hunger. And you know you've said this kind of thing, like, oh wow, this diet is so great, I'm not even hungry anymore. You guys, that's a danger signal from your body saying, okay, she's not eating, he's not eating, so I'm not even gonna give that hunger signal anymore so she can concentrate or he can concentrate on, you know, foraging for food or whatever. You don't wanna get there. But you do want to keep your hunger alive. So train yourself to have a new habit. And guys, habits are your friend. They can either, they should be your friend. They can either help you in whatever goal you have, or they can be a deterrent from the goal you have. Right now, you have a brain habit of dieting. Get rid of that. So back to hunger and how you lose weight with this. You learn to ride that edge. You learn to look forward to hunger and say to yourself things like, could I delay eating? Could I just wait a little bit? Am I hangry? Okay, if I'm hangry, I need to eat. Because if you get hangry and you don't eat, your body rebels later by binging. Yes, it does. Look at your history. Guys, I was a dieter for so, so long, 25 years, ages of 15 to 40. Since I turned 40, 20 years ago, I have been a healthy, thin mentality person, and I want to share this with you. But I know the big comments are always, well, how do I lose weight with this? So you learn to listen for hunger. When you hear hunger, not to overreact, not to say, oh God, I'm hungry, I better eat now. No, let your body cycle through some hunger, because you know what, hunger is not a straight line. And you'll learn about how your hunger works, and that is what you want. You want to reacquaint yourself with you. So, example, yesterday I was kind of hungry, but I was somewhere. I usually always have food with me. That's one of our things to do every day. One of the three things is always have food with you so you don't preventatively eat, because you know, hey, if I get hungry, I can eat because I have food with me. So, you know, but anyway, I didn't. And so I thought, oh gosh, this is not good. I'm really gonna wanna eat. But what happens, and happens to me, it will happen to you too. I am not unique. What will happen to you too is that you will learn that, oh, I was really hungry about half an hour ago, and now I'm not hungry at all. I didn't eat. What's happening? Sometimes your body just sends you a hunger signal, just a solitary few minutes of hunger, and it goes away. Understand that. Understand that your first sign of hunger doesn't mean panic, doesn't mean you've got to eat. And again, it was great. This doesn't happen to me so often anymore, but it was a great reminder to me too that, yeah, hunger is not a straight line. And a couple hours later, I ate and it was fantastic. But so don't feel hunger as a panic. And that is just a simple habit. Just say, oh, I was a little bit hungry there. Let's just see how that plays out. Let's just see if I can go a little ways without immediately satisfying that. Now guys, listen, I am not telling you to get weak with hunger or to get hangry. No, no, no. I'm just saying, just learn, just listen, learn. Yeah, I still feel pretty good. I think I could eat, but I feel still pretty good right now. Let's just see how this goes, okay? You guys, you can do this, and learning to harness your hunger and use it as your tool, as your friend, is the way to permanent weight loss. It is the way to become a smaller eater. And no BS here, guys. In order to lose weight, you have to eat less. Oh yes, there's no getting around that. It's how you do it. And when you do it with compassion for your body, being compatible with your hunger and your non-hunger signals, it's really okay. It's not that diet feeling of, that miserable diet feeling, which I had 1,000 times in my life. Oh, I'm really hungry, but I can't eat now because I'm not supposed to. That sucks. Don't do that to yourself. You don't have to, and it doesn't work. If it worked, you guys, you know, we'd all be, this would not be an issue anymore, but it doesn't work because your beautiful body's like, hey, what the heck is she doing? By the way, you guys who've been with me for a while wonder why I'm always in my car doing these lately. It's because I'm moving and everything at my house and my office is a wreck. So I'll be in my new office, I don't know, in a month or so, and I can't wait. But until then, it'll be in the car, and it's great to be with you guys. Please like, share, subscribe. You can do this. Learn that hunger is your friend. As long as you have the means to answer it, it's your friend. Key into it. Listen. Work it. work your hunger, okay? That's where weight loss is, not fear of hunger, embracing and going, yeah, I could hold off, or yeah, I think I could, I think my hunger is quiet, I think I could stop now. Knowing that whenever you really are hungry and you feel that you need to eat, you should. That's where the beauty is, connecting eating with hunger, connecting non-hunger with non-eating. It is this simple. It really, really is. You can do it. Please like, share, subscribe. Help me get this message out there. Oh, okay. See you soon.